Hey everybody, welcome back to Faster Than Light. Starting a new game here. Let's select our ship. I'm going to go with the third option this time, as I've already chosen the first two in previous videos. So, I'm gonna go with a normal game. I'm gonna get my ass kicked. And that's about it. Just skipping the preliminary story because I've already gone over it. Now again, it's been a week since I played this, so there's a few things I'm probably going to have forgotten. Got my weapons in the front, helm in the back. This is my engine room, and this is my shields. So let's get going. Actually, okay, I just have one laser. Is that it? I just have one laser? But it's Mark II, so maybe it's a little better than normal lasers I would have. Let's start off. I want to try and be as efficient as possible. And of course, I don't want to get stuck anywhere like I did. It might have been my first or second. No, I think it was my first video of this. But I'm just gonna jump down here. Try to min-max this. So your arrival is greeted by numerous computer alerts. The nearby automated rebel scout has used local satellite to deploy a virus to disrupt your shield system. Hopefully it won't cause further problems before you destroy it. Okay. So I have no shields. I might be able to take out his weapons before he even fires on me. And he missed. So that's good for me. I'm just gonna keep on targeting the weapons. I want to keep those down. This drone probably has an auto repair, so I don't want those weapons to come back up. Oh, how do I... Okay, I want that to auto fire. Now hopefully it'll just fire on its own. No, it doesn't. I'll figure that out because I know I... Whoa! Oh, that's my beam laser there. Yeah, I was sure that this had a beam laser as well. So we got some scrap out of there and some fuel. So that was pretty neat. I didn't lose anything and I took no damage. Next sector. Skinners are showing intelligent life forms on a nearby planet. No match for them can be found on the database. So I'll investigate. Don't even know why, in a realistic situation like this, you wouldn't want to be stopping to check out local wildlife. You land a small shuttle in an enormous field whose only occupants are small, brightly colored, six-legged, horse-like animals. Could they be what your scans picked up? Try to communicate. None of your attempts to communicate seem to work. They just stare at you silently. As you prepare to leave, one of the creatures canters forward and forcefully nudges you away from the ship. He seems to want you to follow him. Eventually they guide you to an old NG ship's crash site. Inside, you are able to find and reactivate an NG, which I think is a robot. I'm not entirely sure though. I got some missiles, a drone, and some scrap. And another crew member. Don't really think I have a use for him. I've got 5 right now. But I might get a drone bay or something. I'm not really sure. Providing, I just don't blow up. Get destroyed before I even get a chance to get this playthrough started. Like my previous ones. Scans show a remote settlement being blockaded by a pirate ship. The ship hastily messages you, stay out of this or you'll be next. Concentrate your fire on... So I don't think that I can control this beam laser. It just fires on its own. Yeah, if I can just keep like my enemies' like weapons disabled at all times, you know, I have nothing to worry about. That beam laser sure takes a long time to charge, though. Yeah, just some scrap. Oh, and some extra rewards. I guess I'll start upgrading my power. Put more power into engines. Okay, so mercenaries are swarming the galaxy now. Knowing that their less than legal services are in demand during a period of unrest, one is waiting at the beacon and hails you. So I guess I would have had the option to hire them to delay the rebels. But I don't have enough scrap for that. But I would not have done that anyway. I'm just gonna take him out. Should be an easy win. Ooh. I guess I just want to keep their missiles down more than their lasers. Because the missiles, you know, they just go right through shields. That's how I took damage there. I think that's how I took damage there. Alright. You've made your point. We are beaten. Take these and leave us alone. Is that, I think that's the actual system for the combat drone. So I'm going to accept that. That's a pretty good deal. Okay, so that is just the drone, I think. And then I'm going to need to buy the drone control somewhere. I guess I should be investing in my shields next. So I'm gonna need one more power to be able to afford. Is that even another bubble? No, I don't get another bubble until I have the fourth block unlocked. So I'm gonna need two more power, then I can get a... How is that gonna work? So four more power in total, because I have two power for the actual power, and two power for the shields, and then I can get another shield bubble, which is really important. You arrive at a beacon to find yourself dangerously close to a star. An automated rebel ship, impervious to heat, moves in to engage. And they have drones. But a drone itself won't really do anything to me. Actually, I can take out the drone control now. Mm. Solar Flare imminent. And... oh, that does do damage. There we go. So, I should be good now. They have no shields or weapons. I'll probably just get scrap from this. Yeah, just scrap some fuel. Let's get out of here before that solar flare goes off. I think I can afford a little bit more exploration. Now let's get further in, because there's still some nodes up further ahead that I can explore if I have time. So you arrive to find a number of ships convening around a station. There is some unencrypted chatter between the ships you tune in and listen to for anything interesting. Overhearing their conversation, it seems that they need to take possession of an enemy ship intact. I guess I'll offer my services. They briefly scan your ship and inform you that you are not properly equipped for this type of mission. Okay. I do not mind. We'll move ahead to this distress call. Once you arrive at the location of the distress call, a civilian ship hails you. Thanks for responding to our beacon. Our faster than light navigation has gone haywire and we can't plot a course to the nearest depot to get it fixed. Could you help lead us there? Yeah, sure, why not? So they gave me some scrap. That's a really easy quest to complete. As the node is like right next to me. Usually you have to bring them across like an entire sector. Okay, so you escort the ship to the requested beacon. Much to your dismay, you are ambushed by a rebel ship. You walk right into their trap. It's not, you know, this is like, it's gonna be an easy win though, so I'm not concerned. Ooh, boy. That fire. Actually, we'll get two guys in there. Okay, someone's gotta fix the oxygen. Actually, they can both go fix the oxygen. The enemy ship appears to be powering it faster than light. Drive. I guess FTL. I just don't feel like, you know, saying FTL. It sounds weird to me. But it's trying to escape, and it's not gonna get far. So I got some stuff. I got this stuff. Alright. I think I can go here, and then I'll exit to the next sector. By the time you notice the rebel ship behind the beacon, it's too late to avoid a fight. I don't want to avoid a fight, I want to fight. I want to fight, I want their scrap and whatever else they have. Took some damage there. That's why I need another shield bubble. It would probably be enough to protect me from a laser like that. Well, you know, like when the game's not intense, it's really not intense. Okay, yeah, they're screwed now. Wait, do I need that even? I have three. Yeah, I need one more power. Jump. You've arrived at a long-range beacon. When the FTL drive is charged, you can jump to the next sector. Nearby colony contacts you. We've got a rogue rebel ship harassing the system. Yes, I will find it. I will help you out. So let's blow it up. Actually, okay, they've got drone control. They're gonna do some damage to me. Oh god. Oh, and I think he actually. They're going to kill me. Oh my god. Oh. Maybe I should go down to easy. There's nothing I can do. Like, they've taken out my shields, my oxygen, my weapons. I think I might have to go down to easy, which I really don't like. You know, I need shields. No, it doesn't even matter. I know I'm dead. Alright, so that was interesting. I think for the sake of more interesting videos, I'm going to go down to easy. At least until I get more depth at the game. But I hope you enjoyed it. There'll be more coming in the future. Hopefully I don't, like, get bored of making videos again and take, like, another half a year break. Anyway, love y'all very much, and I'll see you next time.